We had for the concerts in the university. That's where you present. For example, we have presented Hiram Bullock, where we played a program, the music of Jimi Hendrix, where Hiram Bullock played guitar and sang. He's a fantastic singer, and
It's
I also
unfortunate he just
invited him.
passed, isn't it?
Oh, it is a tragedy. I had tears in my eyes when I got this message. We were touring with Maceo Parker in July last year, and I had invited him. And in 2007, in December 2007, I had invited Hiram Bullock to play a production which I called Christmas Revisited. So there were popular Christmas songs, the well-known Christmas songs, played with Hiram Bullock, and he sang the pieces. And when you hear him, Holy Night, hear him singing Holy Night or Tannenbaum or whatever Christmas songs, is this the greatest Christmas production we've ever had? Is this something so special? And unfortunately, he passed away. It was a terrible message. Yes, we were touring with Maceo Parker in Europe when this message arrived us, because in September for last year, I had invited him again to perform. His really personal music and all his compositions had been arranged by Michael Abene. And yeah, he passed away. It's just a great loss, because he was an incredible musician, incredible musician. And he knew also to take all the musicians to him. I had to say, incited and invited the musicians of the band to take part of the music. It was these performances were always something very, very special.
He's quite a
I
character.
Yes, absolutely. There was one anecdote I wanted to say also. Remember, I told you that we played with Hiram Bullock, the music of Jimi Hendrix, in the university, huh? In Cologne. And it was from the 350 concerts I have done with the band. Is this the concert which I have best in mind concerning response of the audience? This was something incredible, really incredible. 2 years later, I invited McCoy Tyner
Oh yeah, that's a great,
to
that's a
perform
great
with the
concert.
band, and I presented the concert also in the University of Cologne. And I was asked by the people, by the mates and by my colleagues, I said, and some of them, are you crazy? How can you present McCoy Tyner in the university? They said, well, Hiram Bullock and the music of Jimi Hendrix,
Work
fantastic.
too.
But how can you dare to present McCoy Tyner in the university? And I said, let's try it. Let's try it. So I remember when McCoy, we performed there, a fantastic audience, young audience, students, mostly students. Fantastic audience. You could hear a fly in the hall. It was so quiet. It was in the midst of the concert. McCoy Tyner played a solo piano part without rhythm group and without band. And it was like an absolute quiet, and really, they really loved
Listened.
the music. And in the break, McCoy had his wardrobe was in a big room, and I saw there was a I don't know how to say a file of students with a program in their hand, waiting, asking to get an autograph from McCoy Tyner.
Oh,
This was so touching to see that young people, beginning of twenty,
it's very young.
were waiting to get an autograph from McCoy Tyner. This was something
Sure, it's
incredible.
amazing,
Amazing. And they came, he was in a very big room. He was, his wardrobe was, it was his changing room, was in a conference hall, where a big, from the university, where all the professors, you know, sitting, a large, large, huge table. And he was sitting there at this large table during the break. And I entered and I asked him, McCoy, there are lots of students who would like to have an autograph from you. Are you, you know, he's aged, and I thought maybe he would like to be just quiet and said, yeah, let them come in. So they came in, and they were all around this table, sitting and standing, and looking to him, really like a big star.
Yeah.
You know? And I remember a student, a girl, who got his autograph when he signed it, and he asked, what is your name? And he gave him an autograph. And then she went out, and she made a jump. You know, she jumped. She was so happy to have an autograph from McCoy Tyner.
Wow.
This was touching. Yeah. This was, you know, when you get this kind of, you know, this, he's a jazz legend,
yeah.
McCoy.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a jazz legend of meets the young generation.
Yeah.
And they react like this.
Yeah.
And then you can say, well,
it's possible. Everything's possible.
Yeah. 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 Because then you see, apart that he's a great musician,
yeah.
and Dennis McCrell, you know Dennis McCrell, drummer, he became very known with working with a very young drummer who started with working with Count Basie Orchestra.
Who is he working with now?
He's working as freelance.
Freelance.
Uh-huh. Yes. Uh-huh.
No, I don't think I know him. I must admit.
He's a fantastic drummer,
yeah.
But he's also a skilled and wonderful arranger.
Mm.
And I invited him as an arranger, as a band leader also.
Mm-hmm.
And he arranged all the music of McCoy for WDR Big Band. He made it. And he directed the band also. Fantastic. Also, I said, his fantastic way of directing the band. Very, very, very good. And what I was going to say, when you see that you bring this jazz legend of, you know, who became so strong in the 60s.
Yeah.
Coltrane. With Coltrane.
Yeah.
And you always associate with him with that era.
That era, yeah.
And then 2004, you present him
at
the university. And the University of Cologne, and you see these young people who really appreciate this music and have absolute respect. It is something where I thought, yes, we really got the target, you know?
You hit the point.
It's just, yeah.